Hey, St. Louis, is it cold to you? Or maybe it's because we have choreographer and performer L. Frost in the house.
And get ready for some dancing because DJ Nune is back.
That's right. We've got an absolutely cool show coming your way with all that and a whole lot more right here, right now on
The Best of the STL.
Of STL TV in Forest Park. It's the best of the STL. On tonight's show, choreographer and entertainer L. Frost heating things up in the kitchen, Acero Restaurante. And tonight's entertainment, DJ Nune.
Música de amor es la música que bailo en las noches. Es el ritmo de vida que me llena todo con fuego.
And I'm Gilberto Pinella.
Oh boy, this is gonna be an awesome show. We got an awesome DJ Nune in the house. And you know what? You guys want to keep up with us. Gilberto, tell them how they can keep up with us.
Of course, you can keep us on Facebook. Uh-huh. We're on Facebook, we're on Twitter.
Yes.
And we are on YouTube. You can see us all the time.
All the time on the social networks. So just stay with us. Also, you can go to STLTV.net and not only find out about us, but about all the fantastic shows we have on STL TV.
Yes, what a great way to communicate nowadays.
Yes, stay in touch, and we'll stay in touch with you as well.
Yes.
Well, speaking about staying in touch, Gilberto, you know, Ivy is taking your spot, Gilberto. It's not fair, but she is. She's in the kitchen.
Yes.
That is the thing I love about Best of the STL. I get to stay in touch with all the hip hop and happen at restaurants in St. Louis. And joining us tonight, Acero Restaurante in Manchester and Maplewood is in the kitchen with us. You want to be here? You want to be a part of all this action? Super easy. Call us 552-2970. We're going to let you have the best seat in the house for one of our live shows right here, 552-2970. Now let me introduce you to Adam Ganal of Acero. Hey, Adam. All right. I just like to say nudie. Mm-hmm. It just is such a fun thing to say.
And it's delicious.
It is delicious. So we're going to be preparing a nudie dish, or nudie.
Yes.
With our clothes on.
Yes.
But it's hot and tasty and very good. What is your favorite dish at Acero?
Oh, favorite dish. Egg raviolo is always a favorite. We also do a slow roasted porchetta, which is a pork shoulder that has a bunch of herbs, spices, garlic, things like that. We also have fantastic scallops. People love our scallops. You would love our scallops.
I would love the scallops. All right, we're going to be back with some Nudie and some Adam and some more foodie here in the kitchen. But in the meantime, I'll turn it over to Huberto.
Thank you, Ivy. I missed the kitchen already. But I'm here with my friend from SLU, the Black Student Alliance, and that is Omar Holt. And Omari, you have some good stuff coming up. Tell me.
Some great stuff coming up. So the Black Student Alliance is hosting its 13th annual fashion show. It's a charity fashion show. It's been around for a long time. We're really excited. The theme this year is the Seven Deadly Sins.
Seven Deadly Sins.
It's going to be May 8th at 7 o'clock in the Bush Student Center.
Okay, and why you're producing that fashion show? It's a very important cause.
Definitely. So all proceeds are going to an organization known as Keep a Child Alive, KCA for short. And what it is, it's an organization that does HIV and AIDS research, awareness, and, you know, outreach in Africa as well as India. So not only do they, you know, provide treatment, but they also help families as far as like feeding them who are affected by this disease.
Okay, what inspired you guys to help such an organization?
Again, it's been around for 13 years. We've helped organizations like St. Jude's Hospital. Last year we did Doctors Without Borders, and the AIDS and HIV epidemic is a major one, and we just wanted to showcase that one this year.
Awesome. So if we want to get in contact, so we want to participate in the fashion show, where do we go?
You can follow us on Twitter at SLU Fashion. You can also find us on Facebook. You can send us an email at slufashion@gmail.com. And you can also get tickets online, slufashion2011.eventbrite.com.
And by the way, talking about tickets, we got some tickets to give away for two people in our studio audience. So do you want to go ahead and get the name?
All right.
Let's see.
And that is?
If you can read it, I can. It's Eric. Oh, yeah, oh, you got it. Is that you? Phillips. Awesome, you got the tickets. Here you go. I can get it right back. Okay, if you want to participate in the fashion show, it's happening on May the 8th. A very good organization at 7 o'clock at SLU at the Bush Center. And for more information, contact them at 977-2814. Omari, thank you very much for doing what you do.
No.
Okay, and congratulations. Now, let's go to Cassandra, who is with some great guests.
I indeed am with some great guests. I like the audience member trying to run on. He thought it was Bob Barker, come on down, but it wasn't. But you know, we're so excited. Today we're talking, Helen Gannon, you won the Lifetime Achievement Award. Congratulations.
Thank you, Cassandra.
Peg, please tell us about why she was selected, all about the award and everything involved.
Great, thanks, Cassandra. Grant Center Incorporated has produced the Visionary Awards for 9 years.
Wow.
And the event itself recognizes the contributions of women in our region to the arts. Mm. And Helen, this year, was among more than 100 nominees.
Wow.
For a variety of honors, and Helen was chosen as the Lifetime Achievement Honoree.
Excellent. Over 100 women.
Yes.
Where do you get all the names from?
Well, we open the season for nominations in December.
Okay.
We select them once they've been gathered. The nomination season is from December through January.
Excellent.
And then we review them through a selection process and end up, we have 7 honorees this year.
Wonderful. Helen, congratulations.
Thank you, Cassandra.
Tell me how it makes you feel to be selected for Lifetime Achievement Award, because as you were telling me before the show, you came from Ireland, you had a vision to come here and do good things, but who knew?
Well, I came from Ireland with my husband in 1967, and I'm honored and delighted to be sitting here tonight, and thanks to Grand Center that they have given me the Lifetime Achievement. You know, people do things in their life, mm-hmm. but to be actually acknowledged for doing what you love to
yes.
do, it's a huge honor, and I'm very grateful to Grand Center for this honor. Thank you, Cassandra.
Absolutely, so well deserved. Can you tell us about what you think your niche was in bringing a little bit of Ireland right here and helping people with that gift that you have?
Well, I've realized that when you come to another country, I realized that what I had wasn't material things, and what I needed was to feel like I was at home. And so I found that dancing, the music, and just giving my children the background that I had as a child opened up a door for me that I could live with. And then, of course, here I am in the American dream, where people just nurture that, and the diverse nation mm-hmm. acknowledges every art form. And so the Irish culture was so welcome, and I have learned about many cultures mm-hmm. being here and sharing it, not just with Irish people, but with people of all races. Mm-hmm. So it's a wonderful thing to be able to do what you love to do.
Yes.
And it's extraordinary when you get a lifetime achievement
for it. Oh, Peg, yes. I mean, I'm sure you had wonderful people to choose from. Excellent. Peg, tell us about what's coming up with the event when you're going to present the Lifetime Achievement Award to Helen. Can you give us some information?
Yeah, the event itself is Tuesday, May 17th at the Sheldon Concert Hall. And we will have, in addition to Helen, six other women. Carol Daniel is our MC. Brown Shoe is our sponsor.
Wonderful.
Our primary sponsor. We expect close to 300 people at the event.
Wow.
And we have, if you'd like to get more information, which we'd love you to ask for, it's rachel@grandcenter.org. is the easiest way to find out about the event.
GrandCentral.org. Excellent. We have it right there, too. And again, May 17th, the Sheldon Concert Hall on Washington Boulevard, the Visionary Awards. I even like the name. Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
Thanks.
Well, we hope you'll come back next year and talk about the next Lifetime Achievement Award. And congratulations to you, Helen.
Thank you
so
very much.
Thank you. And you know, if you want tickets, you can call 314-289-1517. Or again, you can email, like Peg said, rachel@grandcentral.org. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you so much.
Well, you're going to want to stay with us because we have Elle Frost, choreographer and performer, who's going to be coming up on the show. You are not going to want to miss it. Stay with us.
Yo, what up? It's your man Nelly, and you're watching STL TV. Experience the Lou all day.
In times of peace and times of war, in times of joy and times of pain, we need them, they need us, and we need you. The USO, until everyone comes home.
My uncle, what's a special interest? He says they run Washington. He said their groups are special interest in getting bills through Congress or the State House. So I said, I'm a Boy Scout, and our supporters help make a difference by educating elected officials on issues. Does that make me a special interest too? I guess my uncle thinks the Boy Scouts are helping to run Washington. Am I missing something?
Learn more about American democracy by logging on to representativedemocracy.org.
So, do you have any questions?
What is your soup of the day?
We have a mulligatawny soup.
Oh, do you have any specials?
We have a steak special today.
Oh, how's that cooked?
That's pan-seared and then...
Does it come with a side dish?
Is it grilled?
Can I have it steamed?
So, what do you recommend?
What kind of pie do you have?
You an actor.
Aren't you from Ohio?
Any questions?
Ask questions. For the 10 questions everyone should know, go to ahrq.gov.
Welcome back. Our next guest was raised in a military family and was once considered a shy wallflower child, believe it or not.
But Cassandra, he came out of his shell, and now he's dancing.
All over the place, Gilberto. Yes. So you know what? He's dancing for stars such as R&B singers Ginuwine and pop sensation Usher. St. Louis, please help us welcome L. Frost. Oh my God! We should have had you walk out here.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I mean, it's kind of carpet a little bit.
Can you sing and dance at the same time?
Yeah, I do. I just did a show in Chicago, actually, with my boy Titus, and Stephen Garnett was actually filming it. He's a Maxim photographer, by the way. So you know, we're just documenting the whole ride. Had a good time. And I got to, you know, do what I love, which is singing and dancing. So
Now, is it true that you were discovered at a Pattonville? We're talking about Pattonville High School right here.
Wow, in our area.
Did the research show on that.
Okay, tell me about it.
We got the hookup when you come to STL. What do you expect?
They did me? Okay, they did me. No, basically what it was there was a talent show at Pattonville. And I just did an impersonation of Ginuwine. It was right around the same time that So Anxious came out. Mm-hmm. And I loved the little umbrella thing that he did. And I was just like, man, I need to do that. I need to, you know. So I just kind of copied him. And I did my own little version and twist of it. Of course, I couldn't mimic him all the way because he was sick. So I did it. And one of his backup dancers actually was out in the audience. And he saw me and he ran up to me after. Like, I didn't even get to walk off stage. He ran up and was like, yo.
Wow.
So I'm like, yo, what's up? So, you know, I hollered at him and he told me, he was like, yo, how would you like to go on tour with Ginuwine, you know what I'm saying, straight after high school?
Wow. Just like that.
Just like that.
So, wait a minute, was he your only inspiration or do you have any other role models?
Well, Ginuwine, of course, Michael Jackson, you know what I'm saying? You know, without Mike, we wouldn't have the dancing that we do now without him. You know what I mean? So,
and how old are you? Wait a minute. Hold on a second. How old are you? Because this is very important.
Yeah,
24. See, your generation.
Yeah, man, my generation.
That's awesome.
I mean, I'm just glad that I was born in the 80s to where I could actually see Michael at his prime and at his best. I mean, he's a legend. He's a beast. You know,
and
it's
crazy. Just think someone could be saying that about you one day.
Yeah, I hope so.
Now, you were born in a military family, so which means you probably moved to a lot of different countries.
Yeah.
Do you add any of that flavor from some of the places like Japan where you've lived in your dancing? Do you see some of that coming out?
Well, I was born over there really young, and, you know, I was flown over here to the States.
Mm-hmm.
But I used to go back and forth and visit family. But there's one thing that I can say over there is that they take everything seriously. That from the time they go to sleep to the time they wake up, it's perfect. You know, all of this is laid out, their schedules, you know, from dancing. Like, I wouldn't dare challenge any Asians over there in a freestyle battle because they start flying and floating. You're like, what the, you know.
You know, I know about salsa dancing in Japan is really big.
Oh,
so
wow. I haven't seen that yet.
Well, they say that it's really big. So
yeah, you look like you salsa a little bit. You salsa.
I wouldn't compete against you. Let's put it that way.
I don't know. I know a little bit of merengue.
Merengue, a little merengue. Anyway, but so is it your dream to continue the dancing, or are you moving on to something else?
No, I'm actually doing everything. I'm doing the choreography side of it.
Wow.
I'm also dancing in the videos as well. But you know, I'm really focusing on my album and stuff like that because you can only dance behind the celebs for so long.
Right.
Till it's true. Like you want to step out from your own thing. And J-Lo is a perfect example.
Yes.
Jennifer Lopez.
Fly girl.
Yeah, she was a fly girl on In Living Color. You know, she jumped from that and did acting and, you know, singing and all that. And it just kept going and going.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just because you can dance or draw or sing or whatever, that doesn't mean that's what you're bound to because you're able to do millions of things.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's I don't know what part of the brain they call that, the left or the right side, but whichever side is the creative side it allows you to draw, sing, dance, rap, you know, act.
Right side.
You know,
so are you right now giving an advice to somebody that wants to get into your field
I mean, I know a lot of people that are up and coming, and they always ask me, you know, how do you maintain and how do you, you know, stay focused on, you know, just the goals, because mm-hmm. there's a lot of obstacles in the way.
Sure.
You know, yes. And but that's just life, you know, and I just tell them, I say, you know, just stay focused on what you want, mm-hmm. you know, and repeat it. Say it. Say the words out, because whatever you put out in the atmosphere, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? Like it literally the law of attraction.
You gotta
my boy Titus taught me that, you know, yes. it's like whatever you say will come true. So it's like, I can't do it. I can't do it. Mm-hmm. Then you're right. Yes. I can do it. I can do it. You're right.
Yeah, there's a saying, if you say you can't do it, you can't.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, you got to know you can't. What's the best part about choreography? You talked about doing the background dancing and mm-hmm. all of that, but now, as you said, you get to use those gifts to create.
Yeah.
What's the best part?
The best part, I would have to say, is the audience reaction.
Oh.
It's one thing for the celeb mm-hmm. to like your work, mm-hmm. but when the audience is just like, yeah. You know, just like that the whole time.
How do they do that?
Yes.
I take my time. I take my time with it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I don't like to rush many things, because when you do, you get sloppy mm-hmm. and it's not as clean and it just looks like it was just thrown together last night. Mm-hmm. I like to at least spend 2 or 3 days on one song, you know. Mm. Like when I was doing Genuine's Last Chance. Mm-hmm. Like when he first came back out, I choreographed that. I'm in the video with uh-huh. the white tie.
Awesome.
And, you know, it was, he was just like, L, thank you so much, man. And, you know, when we performed it, you know, people was just like, ah! Everybody yes. just did the Jordan part. Uh-huh. Like uh-huh. the, you know. The
Oh, speaking of that jump shot, you're yeah. in the dictionary on the hip hop.
Oh,
I understand.
Wow. You look me up.
I'm talking about jumping. We got some shoes for jumping.
Yes. Yeah, now, right. listen, our gracious gift, L. Frost, is going to give away 2 pairs of his shoes. Greedy Genius. Don't you like that name? Greedy Genius. I love it. And look how sleek they are.
I think I'm going to keep one. I kind of like this pair.
But these go with your suit, Gilberto. All right. Let's draw some names real quick, Gilberto. Here's one for you.
Okay.
And here's one for me. All right.
Let me see. I can read this one now.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, Lamar, Brew Jr. No, Lamar.
All right, he's gone. All right, let's get another name. Let's get another name.
Let's move on.
Right there. And
let's see if I can read this one.
You got to win it.
Tanara Phillips. Yeah, Tanara, stand up. Yeah.
Woo. Stay there. We'll get it to
awesome.
Tanara.
We'll get it to you.
And I have Emily Schroeder. Emily.
Emily, there you go.
You Emily can grow into it. Stay right there, Emily. Let's wave. Get a big wave. Aren't you excited? Yeah. All right, Emily.
Awesome.
Thank you so much, L. Frost.
No,
that's awesome. Yeah. So listen, we got to put out your name, all your information so that people can get in contact with you and support you. We got Facebook.com/L Frost. Also, we got Twitter.com.
And you got YouTube.
Yes.
L. Frost.
Yep.
Music and Gmail. So much information. Sure. We know you're going to be dancing soon and all kinds of other things.
Yeah.
I hope
singing
you'll come
too.
Back. And performing. Singing.
Yeah. And singing.
Gotta hopefully show next time you'll come perform for us.
Yeah, you guys got to check out the music and everything. You know, there's my video is out on YouTube.
Great.
You know, directed by Stephen Garnett. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Awesome.
Thank you so much for coming.
Right, thank you for having
thanks
me.
For the shoes.
It.
All right, listen, you heard about DJ Nune? Well, he's going to perform for you right now, DJ Nune.
You can put your hands together if you like.
with James Brown. DJ Nune has officially become the hardest working man in show business. That was awesome. For more information on contacting DJ Nune, you can go to 314-246-9284 and give him a call. You can also go to ILWAS.com, Ill Was, or LamarHarris.org for booking information. Well, right now we're going to go to Gilberto and Ivy, who are in the kitchen.
Thanks, Cassandra. You know what? We are cooking up some nudie. Now, Frost, have you ever had nudie?
No.
All right. It's a traditional Italian dish. It's not a noodle, but it's made out of like flour and egg and cheese, right?
That is correct.
Yes. Chef Ganao is hooking us up with some nudie. I'm going to let you be the first one to try it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to pull a name here and give away a $35 Sam's Club card.
Wait a minute, Ivy. I may be the first one to try it.
What? Don't be rude. Share with the guests first.
There you go.
Hey, Dara or Derek Cunningham, you've got a $35 Sam's Club card. Congratulations.
Yay.
That's awesome. Yeah, you can feed a whole lot of people with $35 from Sam's Club. But you can also go visit Acero 6 days a week. They've got a very relaxed, very comfortable setting to have some very simplistic, traditional Italian cuisine. Right, Adam?
Very, very simple. Jim Fiala and I went to Italy a couple of years ago. He's gone since then. He's forgetting to take me. But we met a man named...
You must have drunk too much that trip.
It's Italy. But we met a man named Luigi Cataldi Modona. His whole thing was find the complexity in the simple. So that's what we try to do. We use simple stuff to make it good.
It is so awesome and so good, right, guys?
It is so simple and so delicious.
And so delicious. Keep it clean over there. Hey, Adam, I want to thank you for coming on tonight.
Thank you.
El Frost, thanks for being our guest.
Thank you for
feeding
me.
Enjoy
that. Let me tell you, he is enjoying that.
It's a workout dancing.
And I want to thank our sponsors for making us look good and feel good, and our studio audience, who's so awesome. Thank you.
I have to thank our DJ Nune, who's going to play us out at the end of the show. So thanks for joining us, and goodbye.